So I think that the conversation that we are all having on the digital platforms, whether you are on LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Clubhouse, what else is there, is all around how do you stay engaged? How do you stay fueled to be a contributor? I am raising two girls. One of them is presently a teenager and is totally immersed in social media. And one of the rules we have in our home is that in order to be a consumer, you also have to become a contributor. So maybe you are an influencer and what you do is you continually add value. Maybe you are an educator like myself. You educate, empower, and equip your audience like I do. Or perhaps you are behind the scenes. You are a content creator, a copywriter, somebody who takes photos. No matter what your position is with social media, it is really important to contribute. And in order to contribute, you have to stay fueled. And so it's always about how do you stay inspired to have a conversation on social media that gives inspiration and contributes to the audience. And one of the ways that I think that we do that as creators, whether in the throw of it or behind the scenes of it all, is to receive input that is not necessarily connected to your subject matter. So I just recently had a realization, which is why I'm taping this here in San Francisco in front of the Golden Gate Bridge, because it's been a year since I've been in the city. It's been a year since I was able to, all of us are able to really resume our normal lifestyle. Normal may mean going to a coffee shop, to a museum, to a gallery, walking along the promenade, just having an experience outside of your own four walls. I think what that to me has revealed is that we need input. We need that stimulation, that emotional touch, that intellectual stimulation, that input that we get from strangers walking past each other. When you're missing that, you can easily get to this place of feeling uninspired. And so then you just end up with the phone in your hand consuming. And then when you're consuming and you're also meant to be a contributor, you begin to copy because you're not really inspired to create your own stuff. So we are still in shelter in place. We are today in San Francisco and I have never seen a city so empty, which is good and so safe. Everybody's wearing masks unless we are very, very far apart from each other, which is also good. But it also indicates that we're still in the middle of this. So what do we do in the middle of a pandemic still to receive input? I think it's about getting out of your comfort zone. That's what I'm reminded of, getting out of the status quo. So perhaps you can't leave your home and drive to a museum, but you can rent a book at the library about art and just let that be something you take in. And the reason I chose book and not a website is because I want you to get away from your screen. I want you to experience something different, and I want you to have an input, a conversation that happens by phone or 6 feet apart with somebody, a book that you read, something that you turn the pages and you see the next thing, you experience something different. Maybe you can just go on a walk and pick up rocks and look at your rocks and let that be input to you that expands your present status quo. I really think that for us, we are meant to be social. We are meant to be tactile. We are meant to experience our planet, our surrounding, each other. And when you are a creative contributor on social media, you need that input from the outside world. So I would encourage you to try that and give that a good go. Let that be something that you open yourself back up to, because it's so, so, so easy to get stuck in our own status quo. And that's when we start comparing one another, ourselves to others.